Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a concept on net profit margin formula. Now, what exactly this is? See, this is basically a part and parcel of ratio analysis. Let's understand the formula. Over here, there's a formula that is right in front of us, which is net profit margin formula, which is your net profit. That's your first part. And the margin formula is basically the divided by net sales. So you're figuring out the percentage of net sales. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same and you will understand much more about this particular formula. Net profit margin formula is a significant profitability ratio. See, every investor uses net profit margin ratio to find out how much percentage of net profit NP a company has earned at the end of the year. So let's have a look at the formula again. The net profit margin formula is equal to your net profit divided by net sales, this whole into 100. Okay, so this is the formula. Now let's understand this with the help of an example so as to get a clear picture of what exactly are we talking about. Let's say there's a company called Uno, U-N-O, company. And it has some following details, something like this. It has gross sales. Okay. They have their gross sales, then the sales return, the net profit for the year. And this is it. So let's put some numbers over here. The gross profit is 2,50,000. Sales return as $5,000, and net profit for the year is, let's say, $30,000. So over here we know something, that is the gross sales. So what is our gross sales? Our gross sales is 2,50,000. Sales return is 5,000. Right? This is a part of the answer. So our net sales has to be of a gross sales 2,50,000 less 5,000. Okay, less the sales return, that will give us our net sales as 2,45,000. So the net profit which is available to us is $30,000. So let's figure out using the formula of the net margin, we get our net margin formula is equal to the net profit NP divided by the net sales into 100, right? So this is the formula. Let's put down the numbers. The net profit is 30,000 divided by the net sales, which is 2,45,000, and this whole into 100. So what do we get? Our answer should be quite simple. It's 12.25. Right, this into 100 and this divided by your 2,45,000, which is 12.25%. So from the net profit margin example, you know, we can find out that the net margin of Uno company is 12.25%. So if we compare the net margin with the net margin of the companies under the similar industry, this is called the comp company based comparison in the similar industry, then we'll be able to make out an interpretation about whether the net margin of Uno company is good enough or not. Now, let's see the net profit margin of Colgate and understand some real life example details how the companies, real life companies, evaluate. We'll take an example of Colgate over here. Now, we are going to look at the example of net profit margin of Colgate. From 2007 to 2015, we have been given the data. The net income attributable is right in front of us, right? So the net margin is calculated for Colgate by dividing the net profit divided by the sales, that is the net sales that we are talking about, right? So when we do that, the net income attributable to the Colgate Palmolive company is basically it's the percentage that has been calculated, right? And we note that the net margin of Colgate has been in the range of 12.5 and 15%, you can say. So, however, it has decreased substantially in 2015, okay, To 8.6, so this is basically 8.6%, primarily due to the CPE Venezuela accounting changes that has led to this particular thing. So as you can see from the graph, it's 12.8 from December 8, then it has taken a rise, 14.9, 14.2. There was a quiet fluctuation, but at the end of the day, it was around in the range of 14% till 2012. But after 2012, there was a drop, 12.9, 12.6, and there is a significant drop to 8.6% in December 15. So let's understand the explanation portion of the net profit formula. See, at the end of the day, you can learn any formula. It's a mechanical process. We can show any example, but at the end of the day, you should know what is the interpretation. So in the net profit margin ratio formula, we have taken what? The first thing is the net profit into picture. So net profit as the numerator, and because we want to focus on the net profit, we are dividing the net profit by net sales. And because we are finding the proportion of the net profit to net sales, we have to divide by the net sales. Now, for example, if we have the net profit of, let's say, $10 and the net sales as 100, so this is quite evident that it's 10%, right? We don't need to calculate everything. So to find out the net profit, every investor needs to look at the income statement, okay, for finding the net profit of the company. See, at the end of the income statement, the investor will find something that is called as your net profit. Now, in case of the net sales, you also need to look at the income statement again over here, and to find out the net sales, we need to deduct any sales discount, if any sales discount, and also if there are any sales return, then you need to deduct that also from the gross sales to arrive at the net sales. Now let's understand what exactly is the use or the significance of this particular formula. See, by using the net margin formula, the investors are able to understand how much a firm has been profiting from its revenue. So that's what we are able to determine. Now if the proportion of the net profit I'm talking about, if the proportion of the net profit is less than compared to the net sales of the company, then the investor would inquire why it is so, and may find other important details about the company. Third, similarly, if the net margin is too much, I'm talking about the net margin, if that is too much, then also the investor need to see through other details to find out why the net profit margin is too good to be true. Fourth, plus if they know that, you know, the net profit margin formula, it also tells them how much net profit a firm can extract from its net revenue. Okay. Fifth, however, if the, you know, investor thinks that the net profit would increase, that is the NP, if it increase, I'll just write plus over here, proportionately along with the net sales I'm talking about, then in that scenario, the idea is completely false over here. And because there can be expenses that are long-term, will serve the company for the long period of time. And as a result, maybe the net profit would absolutely, it may shrink. So that's why it's important to look at all the figures before ever judging the performance of the company, only through the net profit margin formula. Now this is your calculator for net profit margin formula. Let's put up some numbers over here and do some analysis. Let's say your net profit is $10,000 and your net sales is $100,000. So this is 1%. Sorry, $100,000. So this is 10%. So we can make some conclusion over here. Keeping the net sales as the same, if your net profit increases, okay, then your net margin also has to increase. Okay. Now, coming back to the formula, if we just deduct this to, let's say, 5,000, so your net profit margin has to decrease. So keeping all the things same, just keep it negative over here, your net margin has to go down. And if this both are same, it is going to be 100%, as you can see. So make some analysis based on keeping the numbers, you punch in some numbers based on your analysis, and we'll come out with some amazing results. And make the analysis in this kind of fashion, you will be able to analyze things in much more better way.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.